Hello there, and welcome back to another episode of X4 with our Star Wars Interworlds mod. We are currently in Uta, still. We're picking up exactly where we left off last time, where we had a little bit of a skirmish with some VLS fighters. We came out on top, we lost an X-Wing. Casualties are to be expected. At the minute, we're just in a holding position, kind of defending the gate, and there's a couple of things we're going to do this episode. We're going to start building a defense station in Uta so we can lay claim to it, and we're also going to start a pilot academy sort of thing, because we need some better trained pilots. As I touched on last episode, the patrol, setting them on a patrol in a sector, the pilots don't actually gain that much experience. From what I've seen from various different playthroughs and playing this game, there's roughly five kind of ways your ships get exploring. So going from, getting experience. So going from kind of like least experience to most experience, your fighters patrolling, that seems to gain you very little experience in a very short amount of time. Then you've got the exploring systems does get you quite a bit of experience, but not a massive amount. It takes quite a while. Then you've got trading. I'm missing one here. Yeah, trading gets you a fair bit of experience, but it can take a while to get over that initial hump of getting them from single sectors up. Then you've got the trading for stations, which is, again, can take a while depending on what the station is, where it is. But the one I find the most successful is your mining fleet. Miners seem to get experience quite quick. So with that in mind, what we're going to do is we're going to do a couple of things. We've got our fleet on standby. We're going to tell our Neutron Star Cruiser to essentially... can we get it to... patrol the sector. We'll get it to hold at the minute. It should be all right. Everyone's launched, so if any VLS fighters come along, we're in prime position to strike back. So our secret academy, it's going to be in Manan, because I was trying to think of ways to get this thing a bit more profitable, because at the minute it's not profitable. It loses money on a regular basis. That's because it doesn't produce anything. It relies on everything else. So we're going to go and, first of all, we're going to stick a few solar panels on it. It's not going to make many energy cells, but it'll make some for it to be slightly self-efficient. And then we're going to stick a Rhydonium refinery on there, because Rhydonium is in abundance in this sector, and we can mine that Rhydonium pretty easily. And we'll get a small fleet of tugs. They're going to mine the Rhydonium for us. This will make some Rhydonium cores and sell Rhydonium as well, which we might get a little bit of money for. It's kind of like a loss leader. But this is essentially our secret academy, is what I'm thinking of, narratively kind of speaking. So let's dive into that. We'll do that first. We'll get this building, and then we'll get a defense station underway. So we want standard and we want human. Now I'm actually going to start off with, we've got container storage down there, so we'll start off with the energy cell production, and we're probably going to have to expand this out a little bit. Our little build area. We might actually be able to get away with it. No, we are definitely going to have to expand it out. And I want to tweak that so it's a little bit more line like that, and we'll copy that module. We'll stick another one on the other side like so. So there, essentially, those two, because it's 50%, we're working as one. We're going to need a Rhydonium refinery. Before we need that, we need the storage modules for some solid storage. We'll go with some medium, I think, will be the... Can you not fit there? Just confirm module changes for me. All right, you could actually just plant that way out there. So sometimes if you could... Yeah, there you go. So sometimes it'll tell you you can't fit a part somewhere. But if you confirm module changes, for some reason, it allows you to then place it. Don't know why, just does. That's just one of those things, 180 degrees there. So we've got our little Rhydonium storage, our solid storage. And then we'll chuck in a Rhydonium refinery. Because that will make us money. And I'm wondering, will we be able to squeeze in there now? Not a chance in hell. Or there. We've already got habitation modules, so we'll have crews aplenty. Because what we'll have to do is... It'll be a bit of a faff to jiggle around the crews, but we can do it. We'll have a standby crew of X-Wings. So if we say have five tugs and five X-Wings, the X-Wings will stay stationed on this station or nearby, and then the tugs will get the experience. Say when they get up to 3 stars, we'll transfer them over to the X-Wings. The X-Wings will then, crews will transfer over to the tugs, we'll buy more, blah, 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 blah. Yada, yada. You get it. That's how it all kind of work. I think we need one of you, then one of you, then one of you. No, not a build module. Though it would be very good if we could start building our own stuff. At the minute, we don't really have the economy to kind of support that. I think it'd be more hassle than it's sort of worth. I don't know what that noise was, but I didn't like it. Copy module. We want another one on that side. Have to be like this. Forgot to turn that first. Oh, it's letting me do it this time. Nice, 90 degrees, and then you should fit there nicely. Excellent. And then we can kind of extend this out. As we go. Requesting permission to dock. We get a large, couple of large modules, storage modules in the middle as well. I think that sounds like a good idea if they'll fit. It's a large container. Will you for hell, will you? Although, you might be able to do it like this. Let me do a 90 degree spin on it. Yes. There we go, and then if we go with a large solid as well, or not, as the case may be, we need to expand that out at some point. In fact, we'll do that now. We'll confirm those module changes. We will assign Mr. Tom. Select. And then let's just go back to this station, and I believe it's the Y axis we want. No, it's not. Why, oh, why did we press that? Oh, we're getting some trade in. And just crank that up to about 15. It's huge, isn't it? When you think about it, 15 kilometers, that's a lot. So I want another large solid module. In a lot of ways, this is going to bite us in the backside, because this is just going to be demanding money after money after money to keep it topped up. Oh well. Like I said, its primary function is going to be a trade station, academy more than anything. I'm going to stick a couple more of these on. We might be able to get a little bit of money from energy cells. She's a little bit gawky, but... we can live with that. We can live with gawky. And... if we were to copy this sequence... do that. We'd have to copy that sequence, wouldn't we? Copy that sequence first. And that can go down there. And then copy this sequence. You go there. Yes. That module, and you should go there. He says. Copy module. You're making a big mistake. Oh, who's attacking? Who's fighting nearby? Come on, guys. Let's make peace, not war. Confirm module changes. How much is this going to cost us? Ooh, 15 million, accept estimate. We can live with 15 million. Let's just check what's going on. Have we got any VLS incoming? No, we don't. Who are you? Oh, it's the attacking the Mandalorians. That's fine. Cool, so that's that particular station done. And now we need to establish some sort of base down here. What else do we need to do? Defensive measures? We'll accept that one, so we can... oh, for the Valerian Syndicate? No. I don't think we will build a station for the Valerian Syndicate at this moment in time. I think that might be a bit of a conflict in interest. We're going to go 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. That should be enough room. Create the bot. And I want it kind of there. Continue. And if it's good enough for us to sell to the New Republic, we're going to go with a New Republic 34 gunner. We've got plenty of room to expand on this as well. It's not the toughest station in the world, but it should be enough for what we need. Our fleet's going to be relatively close to this. Doesn't look like we've got enough money to actually start that at the minute, but that's fine. And we'll get Harry on that one. How much can we put into it? Just over a million confirmed. Right, cool. Have we got any other money that we can actually throw into? Look at that. 3 million from our Alderaan mining facility. That's pretty good going. And Bill Brink, they're pharmaceuticals as well. That's good. You can see there, the Manan station does lose us a little bit of money. I'm happy with that though. You don't seem to be making much money at the minute, but that's fine. That should actually go back to the map, give us enough money to stick into the estimate. Accept that estimate. There we go. Cool. Right, so what was that? Right, it's just the pirate flea pots. Now we don't have the power or the firepower at the minute to be able to take on stations. I know this because I tried it and everything got killed without even a little bit of resistance. I thought this thing might have a little bit of kind of like a bit more survivability about it, but it doesn't. Obviously, this isn't a dedicated warship, and the Nebulon B is an anti-fighter. So we need to kind of rebuild the fleets, or we need to build up a bigger fleet. We're very limited to what we can get through choice. And it kind of got me thinking of how we can expand our fleets, because at the minute I like this ragtag fleet, because I love ragtag fleets. It's like one of my favourite bits on Rise of Skywalker, or one of my favourite lines is I'm paraphrasing a little bit, is when the Sith fleet is taken up from Exegol, and everything's looking all doom and gloom, and then the New Republic / Free Peoples of Star Wars rock up in the atmosphere of Exegol, and the guy on the Star Destroyer bridge, he basically turns around and said, "The New Republic doesn't have a fleet like this." And the other guy just turns around and goes, it's not a fleet. It's just ships. It's just a lot of ships." And it's like, yeah, that's funky. That's just everyone pulling together in any old ship that they've got and just kind of rocking up and going, "Yeah, we can help out on this." And then in the last X-Wing book I read, one of my favourite parts is how they take out the Lysanka, which is a superstar destroyers. This is spoilers, by the way, if you haven't read the book. But, like, fair warning, the book is probably like 20, 30 year old by now. So the Lysanka is a superstar destroyer. Same as Vader's executor. To the big super long one, and the way they take it out is they have a fight. It's outside. It's near Typharia. Typharia is very busy with freight traffic. Previously, they'd fitted a load of freighters with missile tubes and torpedo launchers and things like that, and then the X-Wing, the Wedge's small X-Wing squadron, essentially gets target lock on the Lysanka, fires a couple of proton torpedoes, but then the rest of the freighters are kind of like slaved up to the X-Wing's targeting system, so they all fire. So like the Lysanka's getting volleyed by freighters, hundreds and hundreds of missiles at a time, and it's the idea of it is fantastic. So that's kind of like what I want to do with this fleet. We're going to make it a little bit ragtag. We're obviously going to lose out on the firepower side of things because we're not having extra large ships. I'm trying to stay away from full-on warships as well. But that doesn't mean we can't have a lot of ships and go with numbers. And we're going to be looking at things such as the GR-75, which is not actually available from here. But we're going to be looking at possibly VCXs. We're going to be looking at ships. Come on, don't slow me down. GR-75, the battle refit, the gunboat. It's a rubbish gunboat, but it is a gunboat technically. We're going to be looking at the YT-1300. Yeah, Hawks, YT-1300s. We did that kind of thing. The GS-80, which the GS-80, does it say in the encyclopedia? No, because we've not seen one. The GS-80, this is essentially a passenger liner with a bunch of torpedoes on it. So I'm going to build it up like that. So there'll be a lot of small ships, which are technically freighters and things like that. But we're going to do, they're basically going to be our warships. But before we can do any of that, we need a couple of things. We need licenses. So I'm going to go see the Corellians, because I fancy some GS-80s to start off with. I'm going to need some money. So I'm going to have to let this money build up. So the fleet's going to stay here. In fact, the fleet is going to protect our asset until further notice. I'm going to take the Nebulon B, because it doesn't seem too bad for a large ship. And we will see you in Corellia when we're going to buy some licenses. And then when we've bought some licenses, we can get some ships. Oh, and a thank you to whoever you were. Again, rubbish for names. I don't mean it as an insult. I do care a lot about what the things that people comment and things like that. I do appreciate it. Someone told me that there is a shipyard in the Geonosian here's a shipyard for the Geonosians, which is fantastic. I found it. I went back and sent some ships to explore, and we've not found it. And someone said there is the place where you can go, because it is the only place you can buy this thing, a Geonosian frigate, which we might end up with at some point. But these guys should have. Yeah, so they've got some nice ships. It would be nice to have some of these as well. Because the relic ships. But we shall see. Definitely get one of these at some point as a trade ship. We need them anyway to complete the museum collection. We probably won't end up with any of those, because I don't like them. Unless someone really, really, really wants one, and then I'll buy one at some point. So yeah, I'm going to go to Corellia now and buy some licenses, and we will see you in a moment. Right, so here we are at the Corellian Engineering headquarters. We're just coming into dock. Like there's been a wee bit of a scuffle down here. Looks like there still is a little bit of a scuffle. Some A-wings have been destroyed. Who are they fighting against? Oh, it's the Enote Federation. Obviously with the... we need to remove the... Actually, we don't need to remove the orders, because what we'll do is, while we're here... just one second, because we might need to settle this. No. You duck and wait just for one moment, just while I go and sort this out. Because we're probably going to need to go into Setter so we can skip a bit of time so we can get some money up quicker. We're just going to check out how much these blueprints are actually going to cost us. I'd like to buy a blueprint. Actually, no, I wouldn't. We don't need to buy a blueprint. I'm thinking the Imperial one, because we seem to be buying a lot of blueprints at the minute. So if we get the military license first of all, confirm. Map, have we got any free money? Not as much as I would like. So we're going to need another 5 million. But one thing we can do now is what ships do we actually have access to? None. Okay. Now, I don't know what blueprints I actually gave myself on this one for ships, whether it's just the station ones. So, what turrets do you usually have? So it's just the point defense ones. One way we can find out is if we go, I don't know, give me a GR75. Rishi Star, where's our equipment doc? Because one way we might be able to save ourselves a little bit of money, yeah, is we have access to blueprints, is we could actually buy ourselves essentially shells of ships and then upgrade them. The problem is we don't have turret components and things like that at our station at the minute, which we would need to upgrade them. But let's do it anyway. The battle boat. Right, so we want a nice Star Slinger engine. We'll go with the all-round Mark IIs. What's the difference between those shields? Because those are... So again, lower overall shield, but... 15? No, 25 more. Yeah, 25 more on the regen. So we'll accept that, if we can afford it. We've got 3 million at the moment. We... You know, realistically, we should probably save that. We just want the bare bones basics. And then we just want a captain. How much is that going to cost us? Just over 1.5. Okay. So, yes, we're meant to be saving us money, but you can now resume your duties, so you can go back. We'll get this ship built for us, and then we'll see what our options are to upgrade it and how much it's going to cost and things like that, and how long it'll take. It can be our little tester there. Ship. Worst comes to worst, we'll just have to bring it back here. Exam, you can transfer those wares with air. Yeah, get those in. Get it all in, come on. We're going to need them. That is for sure. I wish you could go into Setter outside a ship. Are you built yet? Let's have a look. You can't get the docking platforms. Where would we need to be? Ship fabrication bay, ship dealers. Oh, wrong way. So you got all these wonderful big CR90s getting built, and then they'll be somewhere. We'll be our little darling. I say little, they're actually quite big. Our big darling one. There she is. That's our ship. Being built there, look. We'll have to get some CR90s in. You can't not have a rebel fleet without at least one CR90. Let's go down to the docking area and have a look at it. It'd be nice, but obviously it's for the scale of this game. It's, I would imagine it's not practical at all, but it would be cool if, like, one day, look at that, it's fantastic. Like, when you games where you build, you get to see ships being built and stuff like that. You actually get to see them properly getting built, like arms coming down and welding arms and plates being held into place and stuff like that. It'll come one day. GR75's a big ship. Cool. Right, so I'm gonna wait until this gets built. We need to let some money get in, and then we'll come back when we have that money, and we'll take it from there. This is a good pilot. You might end up getting plonked in an X-wing. Which reminds me, we're going to need to get some X-wings at some point. We need to find somewhere that sells Y-wings as well, I think. Do you sell Y-wings? Just the long probe. We ideally want the bomber.
Beggars are operating on this factory. Please do not encourage these professional beggars. If you have any spare credits,
I'll have a look into that, because it'd be nice to have some Y-wings. Or we could actually see about getting some droid bombers. That could be cool, some hyenas. We wouldn't have to worry about crewing those. Right, cool. Anyway, I digress. We'll come back when we've got a bit more money and we've got that ship built. We've also explored Naboo, so we can buy Naboo ships now. So we can buy the little N1, look. Oh, N1 Starfighter. And we could buy a J-type. I love the J-type. It's got no weapons though, which is a bit interesting. Same as these things. I said we'd stop digressing, wouldn't we? But I obviously told a lie. These things, fantastic little ship, but no weapons. But saying that, we are neutral traders, so we could probably make those work. Especially because they're only less than 1.5
million. Customers are reminded that wares on the station are sold without warranties. Mm-hmm.
R75B.
Okay, so our GR75 battle boat is ready and built. We're going to send it away now to our equipment dock down in Manan. And get it upgraded. Now we seem to have we've dropped on, because it looks like we are managing to get
Dear visitors, we are experiencing some minor surges in our power grid. Please excuse any inconveniences.
We are missing quite a few things though. So we'll stick with the shields that we've already got. Advanced composite. We'll stick with the engines we've already got. We will stick with the thrusters we've already got. And then we've got these different thrusters, so we'll stick with those. We'll get that upgraded. We've got some flares, and we will get the crew as well. So we're just missing 10 advanced composites. So we'll add that to the shopping list and confirm that order. So that's good. So we can upgrade. We can buy shells of ships. We can upgrade them. Which makes even more narrative sense if you think about it, because essentially what we're doing is we're buying.
Incoming ship, docking crews to stand by.
Buying shells of ships, and then we're. I'm just having a look how much we're making here. And so we're actually making quite a bit of money from upgrading. We're just losing out at the minute because we've got nothing to sell. But that should change now because we've got energy cells. We're going to the old logical overview. We should have a sell offer. We'll change that to supply rule 1 so we're not actually buying any in. Cool. Yeah, it makes more narrative sense because essentially we're buying shells of ships without any guns or anything like that. So that kind of looks good as a legitimate trader, and then we're actually sending those on, and secretly, some would argue maybe illegally, refitting them. Okay, so I'm going to hang around here for a little while and get our 5 million up. And then when that's happened, we can buy the other licenses and we'll buy some more ships. In fact, I'll buy the license and then we'll get a couple of other ships incoming. So I'll see you soon. Right, so we're back and we're in the ship dealers. We kind of looked out as the mission, as we stopped recording, it's always recording, but as we kind of like finished up while we stood on the station, the money came in for our new for finishing this mission, which is fantastic. You're not going to work, are you? You're not going to point in the right direction. Can I live stream this? Yes, I can. So this is the new Republic station that we built in Concord Dawn. And it's already being attacked. It's lasting quite well, though, surprisingly. We've got some Stathis class freighter, a few other little ships, mainly civilian ships, some Mandalorian ships. We've taken out quite a few already, so it's a solid station. We are going to send you back to Menando because why not? Flying white. Just in case the Mandalorians do decide to turn on us. Wow, we're actually doing quite well. We've nearly taken out it's the New Republic, innit? Can we get any good views of the combat? Trying to take it out with mining lasers. Fantastic. Little neutron star getting shot up. Yeah, It's a pity that the Mandalorian Death Watch wasn't a neutral faction in this. And a little bit more in then being able to do a little bit more on the kind of like the political aspects of it. So the Mandalorian Death Watch would be a really good mercenary band to have on your side if you could win them over, because then you could have a little bit of a fight for kind of like who can impress them more, who can supply them with a bit more, and have them as the go-to, the kind of like the kingmakers. So if you're the Empire and you can get the Mandalorians to work with you, then you'd have a big advantage against the New Republic, same as if the New Republic could convince them to work for them. You'd have a big bonus. This station's doing pretty well. I know it's only essentially fighting freight ships, but it's taken out quite a bit of tonnage. So it'll have cost the Mandalorians quite a bit. There goes a defender. Just a pity you didn't have more control over the cameras. See, mining ships, like the little mining ship you can see on screen there, they're tough as old boots, and the Heraclin is a tough fighting ship on the Imperial one. Ours have been attacked quite a few times by Vong fighters, and they just chew them up and spit them out, and the Vong fighters have got a decent firepower, and ours aren't even equipped missile launchers, which you can give them. So that might be an idea. Get a little squadron of Heraclons. Right, cool. So, back to the job at hand.
Hello.
I want to buy a ship. In fact, I want to buy a couple of ships, but the main one I want to buy is a GS-80. Now, we'll go with the all-round engines. We'll go with these shields. These shields seem good. Got a good recharge rate. It's decent. Now we are going to buy the missile launchers here and get the missiles on it, just because missile components are usually quite hard to find. But we've got 4 missile tubes on this, which is really impressive. It's got 3 turrets. It's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 laser batteries. It's a very mean ship, and one of the best things about it, which we'll see in a moment, because we're going to ride this one back to home. We need protons. We want flares as well. And we'll have a captain. We'll hire a Corellian crew as well. So obviously this one's not even close to being fully spec'd out. It's only 4 million. We're going to be making quite, saving ourselves quite a bit of money with any luck. We're going to add you to the shopping list. We're actually going to buy 2 of you. Let's just edit and save that load out. Reb GS-80 shell. Or we can spell shell. Nope. Shopping list.
Hello.
We've got 2, and what was our? We wanted those, didn't we? Mark 2s. And those. At the minute, it's more economical for us to buy some things, because we don't have to buy the components then. Basically, you want trade software as well. We need a captain. And we will get a crew as well. And flares. So let's save that as Rare GR75. BB shell. Save his note. add that to the shopping list. And we're going to buy 4. That's going to clean us out, but it's worth it in the long run. So we've got a little convoy for when we return home. Now so I love the GS80. I've never actually done a playthrough where I've owned one or used one, because usually I play a lot of Imperial playthroughs, and ironically the Rebel one that I did, it was more than fighting for the New Republic, and it actually ended up I made best friends with Q8 drive yards, and my fleet consisted of mainly Imperial ships and dreadnoughts. So I didn't actually get much of the New Republic and Rebel and Corellian flavours in the fleet, bizarrely. But I have, when I was looking at this mod, I can't remember his name, surprisingly. I want to say Ulrich somebody or other. He's a YouTuber. He hasn't done much on the X4 stuff lately. I know he did some massive playthroughs, unless he's doing it on Twitch. I don't really watch much on content on Twitch, and I know a lot of people seem to be switching to Twitch, but that is by the by. He did quite a lot of in-depth ship reviews, and the one he did on the GS80, it blew me away, blew my cotton little socks off. This is fantastic inside. So when this is built, we'll have a look.
Customers are reminded that wares on the station are sold without warranty.
Still going up. We make some good stations. How long have we got? We've got 5 minutes. So, I'll not do a time lapse. We don't need to do a time lapse on a medium ship. But as soon as this ship is ready, we will do a mini ship review, and then we'll get in a nice convoy, and we'll fly back to Manan, get the ships upgraded, and then rejoin the fleet. We've now got control of Oita. The system is officially ours. We've got our fleet just patrolling and protecting at the minute. No missiles or anything. No guns on there at the minute. Probably turret components and shield components are always a pain in the neck to get older, but we'll change that because we'll start building our own. So yeah, I will see you in a few minutes when we've got the Ragtag fleet up and running.
You are reminded.
So what I've done is I've sent our 4 GR70s to Manan to start getting their upgrades.
EgoSoft would like to thank you for buying their product.
This is going to be absolute carnage and chaos. Yep. And we're going to take a little bit of a tour of this GS80. We're going to find the other GS80 as well, because that should be done. And we'll do the same with that one. That one is in, I think that one's in internal storage, so we will send you to Manan to also get your upgrades. This is taking a while because no one's getting our components for us, so we might have a little bit of a long wait on that one. I have no idea, mate. That one was the first selected one, so let's go with that. We should have quite a big power plant on that, so we'll go with the KX7s. Because why not? Turrets. Oh, I gave myself far too much stuff. Oh, we could go with some Imperial turrets though. Go with some XV-15s.
Security would like
it's a little bit cheaty, it's a little bit cheesy. If people really don't like it because I've given myself all these things, please do let me know. The reasoning behind it is obviously, narratively speaking, we've been given these by a quite a generous third party who is essentially employing us to run his empire while he goes off on his merry adventures, which is why in this series, so if you've not followed it from the beginning, this series we can't dip into the station accounts. So if it says it needs 11 million, we can't take any of that 11 million. Essentially, that belongs to our backer. We're working for him to be able to fund his exploits and adventures. Good old Uncle Seb. But we can do what we want with the profits. As long as we're making him money, he's happy. So this is the GS-80. It is essentially two, three floors of awesomeness. So you've got little storage areas which are pretty funky on your first floor, and then as we come up we've got these lovely seats. It's just like a little airliner, which I think is fantastic. It's just a great ship. And then we've got more corridors with more little room, so you've got like little projectors, little planning room for navigation and stuff, more seats. This is obviously first class. More first class seating. A random piece of metal. What else have you got? And then there's another floor when you come up. So then it goes up to the next floor, and then you've got a quick access bridge there. All the kind of like Star Wars style padding everywhere. And then you've got this cool custom bridge.
GS-80.
Which is absolutely fantastic. You've got gunnery control, which is this really cool paneling and, you know, navigation control. So when I was in Florida and I went to the Star Wars land, it used to be MGM Studios. Is it still MGM Studios? I don't know. The big Star Wars attraction they've got there. I went on the Millennium Falcon ride. Unfortunately, my fiance, despite proposing to her in front of a castle, in front of the Disney castle, and she is Disney mad, yeah, she wouldn't go on any ride with me, which I thought was a little bit rude, but you know, I love her, so that's fine. I went on the Millennium Falcon ride, and a family let me tag along, and you know, they were doing the pilots and the gunnery stuff and stuff like that, and I was sat in the back, in a console station not unlike this, and I had a number of buttons to press in time to activate shields. I think I was the ship's engineer, which I thought was fantastic. It's such a cool experience, and you know,
hello,
absolutely fantastic. Anyone who is a Star Wars fan and goes there and is a big naysayer about it and says it's awful and yada yada yada, I don't understand why. I really don't, because it's fantastic, it's wonderful, it made me so happy. Yeah, so here we are in our GS-80. We have 40 torpedoes, which gives us, if we're firing full volleys all at once, 10 shots.
GR-75.
essentially. Which is pretty good going. A couple of things we need to do, because our bank accounts are a little bit low. Especially for the plant we've got. Defensive measures. Who am I doing that for? We'll accept that one.
I knew I could count on you.
You know you can count on me. You just know it. We'll claim this plot. We've got a bit of money. So you want defensive station there? How am I meant to get it there? You've got your own bloody factory there. Let me just read the briefing again. What does it need to be? 5x5x7. And it needs 24 turrets, 14 shield generators, a docking area and a pier. And I think we've already got a preset for a 24-gun station. So let's claim this module. I've immediately forgotten what it was. Is it 5x5x7? Yeah, it's 5x5x7. 5x5x7. Training plot. Guys, I'm not giving you much play ability here. Oof, that's a lot. Is that classed as buying the license? Yes, that's fine. Right, so we own the plot, and now we just need to do our usual plan build. I believe, like I said, I think we've already got a New Republic 24-gun station. Let's just see whereabouts that is. Show environment. Let's have it so it's facing more that way towards the station. In fact, if we move it back a bit, like so, we might be able to move it around like that. That seems to make more sense to me. So then, you've got a bit more coverage. Confirm module changes. Let's find a builder. It's going to be one of ours. Select. And it's going to 5 million to make. We've not got that one. That's fine, we can get that set. Have we got a little bit more in the kitty? Nope, we don't. This is gobbling up resources now because it needs more storage equals more money, more funding. So next then I think we need to make our way across to the Aegean Oceans, and I think we need to make friends with those. We need to buy their licenses. That'll give us some money towards building that New Republic 24 gunner. 23 million, we could have actually built my 34 gun one. That's fine. Engage. While we're doing that, we'll have a quick look at our GS-80. So this is a GS-80. It's a medium ship. It's quite a big ship. She is essentially a baby dreadnought. This one's not got the guns on yet. Well, that's fine. We shouldn't be getting into too much trouble, I would hope. And we have got torpedoes if we need them. There's like not a massive amount to say about her. She's reasonable speed. She's quite maneuverable once we come out of travel speed. She's got a good top end speed. 330 plus meters a second. It's a good solid ship. I like them. These are mainly for the sheer amount of torpedoes we can get into these. Engage. These are hopefully going to help us take out the dreadnoughts. for the VLS. We've only got two at the minute, but it should be enough to kind of make a dent in their armour. And they're toughish stat wise. They're not too bad. Hopefully the fighters will be able to put up a good fight. So we've got the Rhydonium refinery coming on, which means we need to buy some mining ships soon. I was tempted to reassign some of these mining ships down here, but they're making us money, and we do need money. Oh, technically speaking, does that go against the rules? Lorena. Hold position. Oh, they're your orders. So we've got ships coming into Manan to refit, rejig. Get all the... oh, that's not good. New Republic jump aren't going to like that. Let me just check what our... What are we classed as? Private company, equal small government representatives may start taking notice of your actions, which won't look particularly good. We are supplying the Anok Federation. We'll monitor that, because that could be slightly damaging to our reputation if we're found to be trading too much. Are you now upgrading? Yeah, it's waiting for those advanced composites, so that could take actually quite a while before that happens. So we will trundle on down to Geonosis, and then we will buy some bombers, I believe, from the Geonosians, so we can build ourselves I'll get ourselves some droid bombers. We might buy a wing of droid fighters as well. I need to check their travel speed capabilities, because probably not going to have any docking room. Well, that's fine. So yeah, I will see you soon. Alright, so we're back, and it's just paused for a second. Nothing major interesting. We're pretty much at Geonosis, but that's fine. We've got everyone off and set up. We've named the GR75's things to do with hunting. So we've got the archer, we've got the hunter, we've got the Jaeger, we've got the snare, and we got the spear. Then we've got the jolly Jewback, which is on bombardment duty for the cruiser. These are on interception for the Nebulon B. These hopefully should act as our little anti-fighter screen. More importantly, and more interestingly, at least to me, I've seen a certain squadron in this game before, and I've only ever seen it once. And now we found it again. It's Rogue Squadron, look, in B-Wings. Rogue Squadron and a X-Wing. Can we live stream view them? Live stream view, look at that. It's Rogue Squadron. The actual Rogue Squadron. I just thought it was another cool little feature that's included in the game. Ooh, that's not cool. Oh, my poor GR75. Why would you do that? But yeah, that's Rogue Squadron. The hottest pilots of the Rebellion and New Republic, apparently. But by that performance, obviously, not so much. Where are we? I think we're in Geonosis. Yes, we are. So we're just going to go and speak to this faction rep and see how many pennies we need. It's going to be about 5 million. So we'll get our 5 million in the bank. How much do we have already? We nowhere near. And is this going to make me very sad if I accept testament? No, it's not going to make me too sad. Let's just set you in a minute. Let's just wait for some money to come in. How's our station? Ooh. I'll accept that one.
I knew I could count on you.
You can count on me. You can all count on me. We're not going to build that yet because that's going to, we've been so close to the jump gate, that's going to be quite an expensive one. We've got this station, which is going to give us up to 23 million. This one, that's going to bring us up to 17 million. We now need to deliver an attack fleet, which is technically a phase two project, but and I would have liked to have done that in our station. But 39 million, can we really turn down 39 million? It's all by the by at the minute anyway, because we wouldn't be able to afford to build that many Nebulon Seas. I don't think we would anyway. Would they even let us get that? Oh yeah. Due to unavailable equipment. Come again. Unavailable equipment. What equipment are you not allowed? Let's just quickly see if we can figure this one out. Open briefing. Quad lasers, RH3, KDY. Is that because it's a Q weapon? Nebulon C? Can you even buy the Nebulon C from there? Nebulon B? No Nebulon C. If we look on the encyclopedia, it should tell us where we can actually buy a Nebulon C. Carriers and destroyers. Nebulon C. Only produced by the New Republic. We've got access to all the New Republic stuff. Alright, what we might need to do on that one. And this is where it probably actually we've saved ourselves a small glitch, is we'd have to buy a Nebulon C on a minimum preset, which would be 6 million, send it to our equipment dock and then refit it onto that particular spec. What? And a high preset turret.
You can go. The scan came back clean.
Thank you. It's the shields, isn't it? It wants. Is it the shields? Yeah, it wants to use. QAT shields, not that. So we'll have to do that. We'll have to buy them as minimum presets and then basically ferry them across to our equipment dock. Which, narratively speaking, is quite good. Fits what we're meant to be doing. We're refitting ships for the New Republic. And we'll get a load of money for that one as well, which will be good. So, we've now got 5 million credits. Come out a setter. Select that. For some reason, on this on the Rebel playthrough, it doesn't always let me select things.
Wharf.
And so if we select. Some things aren't selected. I noticed it with the. I actually asked it on the. Forum. Not a forum, on the Discord. If anyone else was having the same problem. Because it won't let me select asteroids all the time, which is a bit weird. Excuse me. Tis the season where coughs and colds are coming about. Again, it's January at the minute. If you didn't know that, time of recording. Back up. I can't fly. Yeah, it's January at the minute. Oh, this has got no docking computer. This should be fun. It's January at the minute. I'll start again. And we've hit a little bit of a cold snap. Everything else says it's lined up, and there we go. We're in the minus numbers. Apparently, someone said it was going to be minus 8 on the old weather forecast, but I'd have failed to see it being minus 8. That's insanely cold, even for the north of England. So yeah, expect coughs and sniffles and stuff like that, because I'm finding as I'm getting older, I seem to be becoming more sickly and frail. I'm not even that old. It's just seemed to be one of those things. It happened when I started working in schools. My immune system seemed to just tank for the last 2 or 3 years. This is the since COVID. This is the only Christmas I've not had COVID. Right, so military ship, that one. I'm gonna need that one, I reckon. We might as well take that one while we're here. So I think you can get. You don't think you always have to pay for the licenses. You can get it through building your reputation up, which is how I usually do it. But with the third-party factions, keep calling them third-party factions, you can buy them instead, which is, saves a lot of time and a lot of effort. So that should now give us access to some droid craft, which is kind of interesting, because other than probe droids, I've never used any droid craft before. I don't know if they have piloting skill. I don't know how that works. It'd be cool if they were pre-programmed to be amazing. So we got the vultures. So it still classes as a pilot. I would imagine it's it will learn, in inverted commas. How much would one of these on a high preset be? Wow, they're pretty damn cheap. Oh, it's 100 credits. Oh no, it's not. I thought we'd looked out. 100 credits less than what it is. It's not. So we're going to need a bit more money. But that is a droid fighter. Let's have a look if we can tweak these a little bit. We don't need the Mark III. We're going to go with the Mark II combats. I think for the minute, we're just going to buy them pretty much as stock. I mean, there's not many options on these things anyway. A Discord missile? What is a Discord missile doing? Ooh, we'll look at that in a moment. Crew is a pilot. and we've got flares. Cool. So let's save this as Reb Vulch. Reb Vulture.
Greetings.
I suppose we do it as fleet. No, we're sticking with thingies, so that would be escort. Wink, wink, hint, hint. Because we're just traders, we're not hunted pirates. It's only got four. I want to have a look at those missiles in the old encyclopedia. Because this is all new stuff to me. Where's? Well, it's not on the where's, is it equipment? Inventory item. What am I looking for? There we go, missiles. I do this all the, like when I'm I come back and edit to it and I'll see it straight away, but when you're recording sometimes you miss these things. On explosion will attach buzz droids to any nearby ship, dealing hull damage and impacting ship maneuverability. They sound amazing. Yes, we want Discord missiles. So detonation output on the hull, max speed. They're fast and they've got a decent turning rate and a decent pitch rate. They're quite good. Buzz droids, that's amazing. Right, so we want some of those.
Hello.
I suppose the other one we need to look at is the, I think these have an actual crew. Yeah, so this was General Grievous's fighter that you see in Revenge of the Sith. Obi-Wan takes off in it and makes his escape. I think it's this one anyway. I always thought this was called the Jaguar bomber. I seem to remember it being called the Jaguar bomber from my Star Wars fact file. And I'm going to stick with that. And I'll even check it. And if I'm wrong, I'll not admit it. So don't even try to pull me on it. Unless you really want to. But Hyena bomber. Another droid fighter. Needs a pilot. Let's have a look. So we'd want engines. We only got one choice on that. Mark twos again. Shields, the quintets. Wow, these are fragile. These are going to have to be cheap because these are going to be fragile. The weapons are crap on as well. Blaster EXs. Space bomb launchers would make more sense. You've only got one bomb, you're a bomber and you've only got one bomb launcher. What? And you've only got six proton bombs. Wow, you suck as a fighter. It's nearly 500,000. I don't know if these are actually going to be worth it. They're not as cheap as I thought. So it's a mining bomber because it uses the bombs to mine with. But yeah, I don't really like them. They're crap as well. I mean, we might be able to upgrade them so they've got better shields, but then that's kind of breaking the game, isn't it, a little bit. Yeah. They are cheap. We'll get a wing of... a couple of wings of them. Oh, I didn't know the wings on the back of the YVs moved. That's amazing. Anyway, I'm thinking, while we're down this neck of the woods, is it worth trying to get, well, we'll not get the 20 million, but is it worth, what do you need for that? Capital ship. Only 12 million. Seems pretty beefy. The Mark 2s. Ooh. Quad turbo lasers. And missiles, they're pretty mean looking. I really want to buy one of these. Really want to buy one of these. You'd need more repair drones though, if you're going to be in our gang. We have a couple of cargo drones. I'm struggling to think of a good narrative reason why we'd have a Geonosian warship. Okay, I'm going to think about that one. What I did want was the Luca Hub, but we're going to need 20 million to be able to get access to those. Is he? Do you have anything else? What are you like? Brilliant freighter, but a rubbish combat ship. Yeah, you might get a couple of these for some of the stations, though. All right. So, this episode is essentially turning into a building the fleet to secure the system kind of episode, isn't it? That looks like it's completed. Got no guns on it, though, so you're not much use to me. We've got the battle barges. We've got the GS8D. Wow, you all of a sudden started costing us more money. Eesh, that's because of all those storage modules. It's fine. We'll manage. We need to get the mining fleet operational. So what I'm going to do is going to take a little bit of a pause. And get a little bit of money up so we can buy a Luca. It's only going to be the freight one. I know we said no extra large warships. But the freight version, there's two different versions you can buy. You can get the freighter version, which is this. It's a freighter. And you can get the warship version. If we look at the ICG, is the battlecruiser version. We're going to get a freighter version. So essentially we're buying a big freighter ship. Oh, we could get a control, a Luca Hull auxiliary ship as well, which is pretty cool. And we're going to try and fill it with some droids. And that's going to kind of be our flagship, I think, for this ragtag fleet. They're escorting us on high-value trade missions, aren't they? Narratively speaking, that's what it's all about on this series, trying to make it narratively sort of make sense in a kind of not make sense way. We're essentially turning into the what the Trade Fed. So in the Star Wars lore, the Trade Federation started out as quite a noble group of people, and they were from what I recall anyway, and that they were kind of just wanting to protect trade drains and stuff like that. But then they actually became as bad as the people who were trying to protect from all the pirates and stuff like that. And, you know, then they started overtaxing and gaining monopolies and stuff like that. So, yeah, we're turning into the Trade Federation. I'm fine with that. We're hunting pirates. We'll wipe out pirates. We'll be noble. So I'm gonna see if we can get a Luke Hulk for this episode, I think, because I don't think 20 million is actually a hard thing to achieve with how much money we make. So I'm gonna get in my GS80. I'm gonna go in Setter. We're gonna try and find some station building missions, and we're gonna get those accepted. Because when we've built that New Republic station, that'll cover a big chunk of money. So yeah, we can do this, guys and girls. We can do it. So I'll see you very, very soon. Okay, so tiny little update. We've managed to get enough money to buy the license. It came through when we completed the Corellian Defense Station for the New Republic. It has come with some slight consequences, though. It looks like our ratings have been hit slightly. So the Mandalorians no longer want us to trade with them. The Imperial Ascendancy, which doesn't matter because they're pretty much wiped out. And the Galactic Empire. If we look at our faction relations, we're now at minus 10, which means they won't be actively hostile towards us, but it's going to get a little bit tricky to do our defense missions. That's not a problem. We will we'll get by. See, can't click anywhere on the station. Oh, it's because it's there for some reason. Maybe daft that you have to click on the hitbox. Anyway, I digress. So we're going to go in and buy the license now. We're waiting for the Geonosian station to be completed, and then that'll give us another hit of money, and we can buy the Luka Hull. I think we'll call it an episode there, because this is taking a little bit longer than I thought. But we'll end with a little little walk around with the Luka Hull, because I know a couple of people were wanting these. You can tell I'm a bit tired. Where am I actually meant to be? Just because I don't have a docking computer. Alright, so I need to go this way a little bit. And I need to go backwards. There we go. Yeah, you can tell I'm a little bit tired. Because I think it's about 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning as it stands at the minute. I've been recording for about 2.5 hours. There's stiffness, there's soreness. But it's all worth it because it means we're making progress on this Rebel Trader series. I think one of the things that we're running a bit short on is we're falling down on finishing some of these stations is advanced electronics. It seems to be a bit of a shortage. That's fine, we can manage. Show me your licenses. Give me that one. Thank you. And that leaves us with 4 million for now.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. And while we're here, we might as well Well, we need to work out how much we actually need. Let's go back to the GSMT. For our Luca Hull freighter. How much is this going to cost us? Excel. So now we can buy every. Oh, we can buy. Munificent. They were a funky looking ship. How much is one of those on a high preset? Ooh, that's a lot. The Recusant class. Again, it's a lot, but it's not a massive amount for a full-blown capital ship. They're relatively strong. They've got relatively amount. It's a good hit point. Yeah, it's a bit... for an extra large ship, that seems pretty weak. Great turret output.
Please remember to return your depleted energy cells to the recycling
plant. Yeah, and that's Gargantuan turret output. These engines seem pretty... weak though, bit thingy. So let's build ourselves a Luca. My name is Luca. So obviously we've only got one choice for engines. We can go DZ9s, or we can go 440 Palisades. We're going to go with regen on the engines. I think that makes sense. And I'm actually going to go Mark 1 on these because it doesn't seem to make all that amount of difference. This thing, it's not going to be maneuverable. Just looking at this then, so we've got two medium docks and 42 small ship capacity. I don't know if that means we've got additional medium ship capacity. So would that be four medium ships and 40, 66 more fighters maybe? We'll find out soon enough. I guess we'll be going with those shields.
It's already starting to cost us quite a bit. Any space weed consumption aboard this station is against the law.
Now, I think what we're going to do is fly this back unarmed and we'll gun it up at our station. Is that tractor beams? Wow, she got a lot of guns. She got a lot of guns. It will need flight software, it will need a long-range scanner, and a basic scanner, and a trade computer. Oh my god, and she's going to need a captain. We'll give her a skeleton crew, just to get her home to our base. And that's going to cost us 29 million, which, you know, it's not bad for a big ship, a ship of this size. Plus whatever it's going to cost us in materials to get it upgraded. So we will call this the Reb LH Shell. Save us now. And I guess now it's going to be a case of wait until we can get 29 million in the bank, and then we'll get a couple of wings of fighters, droid fighters and droid bombers. So we'll get 10 vultures and 10 hyenas just to give them a go. If they survive long enough for what we're using them for, then we will buy some more. If they die straight away, then we will know that they are not worth the money as it stands at the moment. One of the things we'll have to try and have a look at some point, in fact I might send one of our exploring ships to try and find it. The one of the new ships is for the huts, and it's a Sorosub something, and it's a trade ship. We'll have a look at that. We'll get one of our explorers out into the hut space. Now Hutter, I think, is one of the places with the shipyards. So up this way. In fact, we'll get them doing that now. I'm sure I've got an exploratory ship. We've got this one exploring down here, looking at the... We're now into kind of like unclaimed sectors down in this sector of space, outer rim. I think this is the outer rim. You got the outer rim. On the actual map, you can't zoom out far enough, but on the actual, you look at the Star Wars map, it's kind of like outer rim territories, unknown regions of this far end, and then has it got wild space or something like that in Star Wars? I don't remember. Right, so you are going to find me a hut base. I want to see this new ship. Ooh, in fact, you're going to be smart and you're going to go through Bothway. I might actually find it that way. Other than that, it's just a case of now we're waiting on this one being completed. That's good to see we're getting the weapons in already for that one. We can accept that estimate, and that'll get us enough. How much are we actually getting paid for that mission? So that one is up to 17 million. Oh, got a message. Oh, you've been stripped of the rank. You know, Federation, they don't like us now anyway. That's fine. The lines are being drawn. It looks like we've kind of started arming ourselves up at the right point in time. That's not going to explore anywhere near where we need to be, is it, Mr. Wiry? We'll just explore around the gates. I've noticed now, if you click on the explore through the gate, it tends to just do a little section. One of the main reasons I'm exploring so much is because I'm after the Katana fleet. That's what I'm trying to find. We've not found any yet. Sooner or later we should find some of it. So you're going through Bathaway. Are you going to Rorak? Trying to remember where now Hutter is. Hut space isn't that big. I think it kind of goes parallel with each other. Does it go around there? We'll see. We'll see, and we'll find it. And when we do, we'll have a look at that ship. So I'm going to do what I do best, which is basically sit here and play X4 RTS style. Does feel a lot like playing something like Civ when you're playing it like this, or playing it like basically like playing it like Stellaris. Which is nice. It's nice and chill. Not as frustrating as sometimes X4 can be when you start doing all the combat-y stuff. So, I'll see you very shortly. Okay, so we finally got the money, and I've had to wait a little while because the prices went up by quite a considerable amount. At one point they were 40 million. But we've now got it at a decent price of 30 million. It's just the shell that we need. So we're going to add that to the shopping list. And we're going to confirm that order. And while we're at it, we will have a look at how much we probably need the bombers more than we need the fighters as it stands at the moment. They're going to be 410 each. We can get 10. And vulture droids. Let's show up in this. Can we get another 10 of you? Yes, we can get 10 of you as well. So we'll confirm that order as well. Which is fantastic. You can actually hang around in this sector of space, because why not? And we can watch a Luka Hulk get built. How long is it going to take? 25 minutes. So this is the Luka Hulk. She's a big bugger, to say the least. And there's one they made earlier. She should be a nice ship. She doesn't fit in the docking bay, which is making me a little bit scared. Because if she doesn't fit in the docking bay, are we going to get a... explosive exit, or is it just not going to fit? Are we going to have to fly away and let it sort itself out? Who knows? Well, we'll find out. We'll have a quick look at the vulture droids and the hyena bombers as well, as we get them to come and dock with our new ship, our new trade ship. Really could do some name suggestions as well, if people want to drop those in the comments. Because at the minute, name I've been struggling to think of names of ships without them being like massively cliched and like overdone by other like series and things like that in the past. Let's just have a quick look at what else. Are the vulture droids ready yet? Oh, we got the hyenas and we got the vultures. So we can tell them, come out a setter a minute. Can we tell them to fly and wait here? And we'll pick one at random. We'll go F3.
F3. Vulture droid.
Oops, sounds like someone's just refused to comply with an order for a search. So these are the vulture droids. These look nice, don't they? A nice looking little ship. Suit the what they looked like previously, and we crashed. Check out if these. God, why X4? Why do this to yourself, to me, to everybody? So I'm pretty sure we can't pilot these. They're like a robot control. Well, they are robots, aren't they? Big fighter robots. I don't know what the speeds are on them as well. So we'll have a look at that in a second. Nice model though, really nice model. Looks good, seems to act in the way that you would want it to act. But let's look at some of the stats, because we didn't excuse me, look at them. So we've got a cruising speed of 327, which makes it pretty nippy. Crew skill is two out of the box. Can we, will we be able to teleport to? Yeah, we can't teleport to those ones. They look good. And then we got the hyenas as well. The hyenas is basically just a vulture droid with a bit more bulk to them. Let me get you to fly away here. And can we have a look at you?
Hyena droid.
So kind of playing on that basic idea of a TIE bomber. Kind of like a double cockpit, essentially. One pilot cockpit, the other a bomb bay. They seem to fly quite nicely. Nice little striping camo pattern on them. Yeah, they look really nice. Really nicely rendered. Nice and smooth. Is what you want to see. I like the glow on them as well, on the eyes. They do look mean. So that's cool. Right, so we just need you to finish now, Mr. Luke Hulk. Come on. That's all we want. We want the big boy. I want to see how badly this essentially fails when it tries to come out of the docking bay. Unless it's designed so like these bits here can are clippable, so it can clip through. Because I very much doubt there's many people that actually enjoy sitting and watching ships being built. In X4, maybe there's, but I doubt it. I usually watch the first kind of like ship of a class be built, just to see how they react and how they move and stuff like that, and then usually you're building them from sectors away. Through your map screen. Getting the last couple of bits finished on her. Be interested to see on this one as well what the interior's like. What sort of bridge have we got? I don't think these do have a custom bridge or anything like that. Do apologise if that's coming through, but I can't stop yawning at the minute. That's because I'm very, very tired. As I already said, it's 2:20 in the morning. Ooh, ah. Last few builder droids being done. Usually, it auto ejects them from port unless it's stuck. I like the lights on it, the laser lighting. Reminds me, this ship does remind me a lot of, and I think I've said it before, it's kind of like the cross between, is it the Aberth class from, oh it comes out nicely, look at that. From Star Trek. See you later. The dodgy looking science vessel. So it reminds me across of an old berth and the alien ship from Aliens. The, I can't remember what it is, the one with the giant people in it. The crashed one is in the first Aliens film. It'll come to me. And then they did the the prequel sequel thing with Michael Fassbender. Are they the Watchers? Why does the Watchers sound familiar? That's another good science fiction series, Alien. And how they meshed it together with Predator as well. That was good. And how much Predator has got lore-wise. When I was a teenager, I really enjoyed the AVP stuff. And it led me down like the rabbit hole of finding out more about the predator species and the culture and the hunting and the are they called Yautja or something like that? Something deaf like that. Yeah, very cool. So this is Luca Hulk. It is absolutely humongous. And we're going to tell our hyenas. You are going to bombard for the commander. And we're going to tell our vultures to just have them on defend for now. And let's watch some of these hyenas come in, see if we can get a feel, a cinematic feel for them. Most likely what's going to happen is they're just going to crash into the sides and bounce off each other and ruin all my cinematic hopes. Can we settle while we're in it? No. Giant space donut. Now you would think that these hyenas and these droid ships would know how to dock with this pretty easy. I don't know where you're going. What would be very cool is if they kind of like, instead of docking inside, they deployed the little droidy legs and started scurrying along the hull. I don't know where you're going. This is a big ship. Will this even fit through the gates? Oh, we picked the one that's let's get set her. I feel like it's doing the twitchy thing and set her. Should we just tell them to dock and wait? Oh, are you doing it automatically? So we'll do it the old-fashioned way. Dock and wait. Dock and wait. So it looks like we've got multiple entry points into a Luca hull. Now I am actually thinking that these are probably going to be pretty rubbish as a battleship. Or a little warship. Just for the simple fact that it is a trade ship, for one. And they're probably geared more towards being a command carrier rather than an actual thoroughbred warhorse. That is a huge ship. Absolutely huge. Right, so are we allowed to dock? We should be allowed to dock. One would imagine. Docking granted. Also, it looks like it's a yo-yo style docking entry point. So let's get ourselves lined up. Sneak forward. Oh no, we need to be further this way. Down a bit, back a bit. I really need to get a Mark II docking computer installed on this. In fact, tell you what, we'll do the next Bex thing. We will go GS80, dock and wait. Come on, Captain Alden.
Hello there.
Hi. You may resume your duties. So this is by no means a small ship, and it is completely dwarfed by this boy. Come on, you're making me look like an idiot.
Can I help?
Yes, proceed with current orders, please. So when I was piloting the ship, you wouldn't let me do that. Well, that's good. We just kind of like sit there. Although I would have liked it if we went a bit further in, and then we could have reenacted the whole scene where the CR-70 goes in and it gets shot. Right. So we just need to dock those vultures now, and then we will get out and dock and wait. There we go. Orders are given. You have the bridge. I'm going to the bigger bridge. I'll be taking my own personal private elevator. Thank you very much. All right. So let's have a look. See. Wow, she's big. Wow, she's very big. This is bigger than a station. In fact, this is like a mobile station. I can't go that way. So, right. So, you're kind of limited to certain places you can go, which is fine. Because I would imagine it's very easy to get lost on this ship. Have we got any other vultures coming in? Oh, they'll probably go through the side entrances, won't they? I'm sinking through the floor. Cool. Let's have a look at this bridge then. Le bridge. Oh, so just standard X4 bridge, which is fine. As cool as it would be to be on a the kind of like Phantom Menace style bridge going through all the corridors and stuff like that. I would imagine it'd get very tedious very quickly. Okay, are we all docked up? We are waiting for one more vulture droid. Come on, what are you doing?
Vulture droid.
Oh, you're all docked up. Excellent. So let's take this thing for a spin. We need to go to Manan. Set our destination, please. Is there any missions around here? Just before we go, though. So, let's test her out. Let's go for a little spin. So, she is slow. But what would you expect? She's very slow. In point of fact. Couple of things I've done while we've been waiting to get all this stuff. We've renamed the equipment dock to the Academy of Mining, where you go to learn to be a miner.
Jump beacon.
Sort of half glibly, half arsing the whole narrative perspective on this. We are working to a narrative. We're just not playing it in a narrative style. One day I would really love to sit down and come up with some sort of a full-on narrative story and see if we can make an X4 style movie. I have seen it done before, but it does kind of rely on third party stuff and a lot of like 3D modeling and animation and stuff like that, which I've done animation before. I've not done any 3D modeling before. So yeah, might be a bit tricky to pull it off. What would also be very cool on this game, she looks pretty good. How fast do we go? Slow. She's a slow old girl. But she gets the job done. What would be good on this game is if they included multiplayer, or if someone can mod it to be multiplayer, or if it's already done, if someone would let me know if it's multiplayer. Because multiplayer on this mod, I was thinking about it the other day, we could do a hell of a lot. That would be something I would quite happily pay the money to have like a dedicated dedicated server to we built that station up. Yay, look at us. Yeah, that, you know, I'd pay to have the server for that. How are we gonna fit through it? Oh god.
Autopilot disengaged.
Right. Is this going to be... That was with autopilot on. This does not bode well. Oh, this could be a frustrating ship. Yeah. So I'd happily rent a server. If that's still a thing. If people still do that nowadays. I remember on the good old days of Minecraft, way back when, in the olden days, when Tekkit was a good solid mod for Minecraft, I used to have a server for me and my mate. Mainly. I can't remember if we had anyone else on it. I think it was just us. That was good. And I think, yeah, it kind of drifted off a little bit then. Yeah, I think this game would be excellent for a big multiplayer server. We could get some factions set up, have some wars, get some trade, boost an economy. Obviously, you'd have to probably have some form of rules and stuff like that. Just so it doesn't turn into absolute chaos. Right, let's just have a quick look at this. So we need to maneuver ourselves round. Will we fit through the gate? I don't know. I don't know if we will fit through the gate, you know? Surely we must. Is this a ship that wasn't designed to be kind of like piloted by human beings? I mean, with the way it handles and stuff like that, it's a ship that's cool to own. I don't think it would be a ship that we would personally command This is in setter, by the way. This maneuvering, just in case you wanted a point of reference. Oh, we got there. We got through. Completed. Right, let's try that autopilot again. Hard sell. Those are always bigger than I imagined. Obviously, they're a big ship. You kind of get that idea of scale on the Phantom Menace when they're coming down, but I didn't realise they were that big. This is going to be painful in autopilot. Let's see. Come on, let's get charging. Let's go, Eskimo. Don't worry about all the little ships around us. Just fly through them. So full boost. We looks like we'll be able to get up to around about 200 meters a second. Yeah, just clocking out at 199. Would not like to try and turn off the automatic pilot assist on this. I think that would be fun. Well, mind you, saying that, it's slow as old slow, isn't it? But it's okay. We will get it to Manan. We will get it upgraded to the highest we possibly can, and this will be our command freight ship for the privateer fleet is what we'll go with at the minute. Right, how are we looking on that? Are we gonna fit? Oh yeah, she'll get through there easy.
Jump completed.
Okay, that's fine. Autopilot. Right, so engaged. I'm gonna leave it there for this episode. And we'll put that together. It wasn't the original plan was for this episode to go in and Why is the fleet there? Okay, right, you do. How did you see that? That was originally a VLS one. I'd love to know how it changes its ID. I'd love to be able to do that myself. But yeah, it was originally to go in and attack some of the stations and stuff like that, but when I originally tried it, it was just... It wasn't even entertaining chaos. It was just, we just got destroyed really quick. So this is the kind of like the ragtag fleet building episode. I'm going to probably do a little bit more behind the scenes and buy some more ships. There's nothing going to be big or exciting. It's going to be a kind of like little ships to kind of like see what we can do and what we've got together and things like that. So I hope you've enjoyed it. As ever, if you have any questions, any queries, if you want me to do anything different, anything, you want to see anything, any particular ships you would like, if you would like any particular ships and you want them naming after yourselves, do not hesitate to drop a comment and ask. And I will do whatever I can to accommodate that. I have actually got a list somewhere, which I started putting together, of names for ships based on Look at these. Look at these poor Imperial Ascendancy. Since this new update, the Imperial Ascendancy seems to get battered like mad. Like, that could well be the last Imperial Ascendancy station we're looking at there. Because everything else is gone. And they've got no defence stations. They've got one there. They've got an engine component. But for all intents and purposes, they are gone. Oh, right. Yeah, sorry. Before we go fully, that was one thing I was going to do. Because I found the place that sells the new ship. So it's the luxury yacht as seen in the Clone Wars. It's not a small ship, it's a medium ship. And it's this one. It's kind of like a sort of sail barge design. It was in the Clone Wars. It was, I think there was a slightly more beat up version of this, which Obi-Wan briefly piloted with Cad Bane and everyone on that episode where he went. He did the whole face off thing and became a bad person. But yeah, it's 2 million. I think I've seen it 1.5 million if you go minimum presets and things like that. That's without the guns. I can't remember as well this ship if in the Legends this is what Lando has. Or he has something similar to this, if I remember rightly, called the Lady Luck. What we got? Mandalorian patrols? Hot pirates? Whereabouts are we? So yeah, so that's one of the, I think that's the last new ship we can get. We're going to see about getting a couple of mantises as well, because I quite like the idea of a mantis. And this is goddamn painful. So, as ever, I've rambled on a lot. And I've turned I've turned what should be a simple sign off into like a 5-10 minute spiel about crap. We're gonna accept that mission. No. Yeah, we're gonna I'm just gonna crack on with stuff. And I will see you next time. Thank you for watching. You've been wonderful. I'm going to bed now. And I will see you soon. Goodbye.